In today's video, I want to speak to you about design hygiene. That's a term I coined to refer to creating clean files, beautiful, clean, professionally organized files that all your stakeholders will love to navigate through. And it will help them understand your content and all the designs that you've created much better. So how we're going to do this, I'm going to guide you through the file. There are a few basic things that we want to go through, from creating a cover for every file that showcases who is working on this file, what's the name of the product you're working on. We're also going to go through file organization, how to organize your file in an optimal way, how to prepare certain layers in Figma or certain sections to be ready for dev to facilitate developer handoff as well. Let's jump into the file. First of all, let us look at the value of a thumbnail or a cover. Why do you need it? When you're a team or a designer working with multiple projects, after some time, it gets very overwhelming. So this is my file view. And can you tell me what's the difference between these projects and the other ones? Well, obviously, the difference is the thumbnail. These two projects have a thumbnail that is set correctly. This particular one here, the course slides, has a thumbnail, but it's not properly fitting. So something is wrong about its dimensions. The rest of them, they don't have any cover, which makes them very hard to see from a distance or recognize. So let us dive into how to create a thumbnail or a cover. In this cover project, which I will link to in the video description below, I've given you four examples of a cover. Now, the most critical thing that you need to be aware of, I'm going to click Shift 2 so that I zoom in onto this particular cover. The dimensions to set a correct thumbnail is 1920 by 1080. And this is one of the default frame sizes that are provided to you by Figma. So if I were to back up and if I wanted to start from scratch, if I click F to start with a frame, under presentation, you will see slide 16:9 is a default size with 1920 by 1080. And that's where you would want to get started if you're not using a template. If you choose to use this template, I'm gonna zoom in again. Here are some recommendations. You can choose whatever background color that matches your brand or what you're working on. I recommend on the right side, maybe have a visual that represents your project so people can recognize it. This is a screenshot of one of the projects my student Wallace Zhao did. He did a wonderful mobile application that I wanted to refer to. You can use a product name, a feature or task name, because under a particular product, very often you're working on different features at different points of time. You can use these tags to show the status of the project and when it is due. And then you can list the product designers or the different team members as you please. Now, once you've finished creating the cover for your project that you're comfortable with and that you like, you right-click on the cover and you select the option Set as Thumbnail. Once you do this, Figma will give you a notification, Thumbnail Set. Now, what this means is if I go back to my files, I will see this is the thumbnail for my project. For some reason, it's black. Let's try another one. I'm gonna set this one as a thumbnail. And now I'll go back to files once my thumbnail is set. And you can see it changed it right here. And it is the perfect size, it's not cut. Now let's talk about naming your pages. So when you hand over a project to a stakeholder, whether they are product managers, engineers that are going to execute the project, or a professor, like in the case of Wallace here, it's very important that you organize your pages. Recently, Figma has added the capability of resizing this layers panel. Very helpfully, the panel, we call it a layers panel, but it contains all the pages. And it also contains the layers within a page, and you're able to move that up and down based on where you're working. So make sure your pages are well named and organized. Within pages, Recently, Figma has created the ability to make separations. So for example, if I wanted assignment 1 and 3 to be clubbed with a separation in between, I'm gonna click a new page after assignment 3. I'll write 3 dashes and hit enter, and automatically Figma recognizes this is a separation and not just a page or an empty page. You can do that as much as needed. You can separate your exploration from what is actually completed and finished. If you want to rename just one frame or one layer, it's very easy to double click on it. But let's say you want to rename multiple layers. So I want to change the name of all these frames with the slides. I click on the first one, and then I hold shift and click on the last one. And now once I have all of them selected, I click Command R, which will open up the rename model from Figma. And this will allow me to rename 12 layers with some added logic. So let's say I want to call all these slides week 1 to avoid confusing them with other week slides. And I'm just gonna add a space, dash, and now I wanna add the current name of that particular slide. Whatever it is, I wanna retain it. It's very easy to do that. They also have options to do ascending numbers or descending numbers. It's very helpful. Now, if I were to click rename, you'll see week 1 is added to all those slides. Let's say I have many layers that are open and it gets very confusing in the layer panel. One of my favorite shortcuts is it's Option L on a Mac or Alt L on a Windows. And what it will do is it will collapse all your layers. So if you have multiple layers open and you want to see the big picture, Option L or Alt L will collapse everything to give you a better view of all your frames. As your project approaches completion and you want to prepare it for engineers who will be your main stakeholders to receive it, it's very important that you organize it with that focus. So let's say this is my project. Now I want to add separation between all the work that I have done and the work that I want to hand over to engineers. So I create a separation page, I'm going to create one more page, and I'm going to call it Dev Ready. And maybe I will put this on top of the separator, and now my developers will know that everything within this section is ready for them. So that's one way of doing it through the pages and the layer panel, but also within a page. Let's say I am ready to hand off this work. As you can see, not many people are aware of this, but you can change the color of your Figma page so that you can create enough contrast for your stakeholders. Whatever is the color that you choose to use, you can do that, and it gives you proper contrast for your page. But also using sections is very helpful to combine multiple frames. As you can see, if I had multiple sections, I can change the size of the section, I can duplicate the section, I can change the section color also. And most importantly, once a section is selected, you can change its status and mark it as ready for dev. Now, what this does is it will highlight this section. So you don't even need to do it through the layers panel, because if I were to go here to dev mode, just to get a view of how my developers will see my file, what is most visible in dev mode for developer is what has been marked as ready for dev. That's how they know that your work is ready for them to inspect. And once they inspect it, they can see all the elements that they need to see. Remember, keep your files clean and well organized, because they will be much better received by your stakeholders, whether they are engineers or product or other designers. Thank you so much for watching. If you found this video helpful, please like it and subscribe to my channel.